In this exercise, we will examine the maintenance procedures for our Magnum Series Warthog WGR, our new 1-inch nozzle for sewer jetting. The innovative WGR is designed to operate with either recycled or freshwater sources and features viscous fluid controlled rotation for more effective cleaning. In this video, we'll review disassembling the tool, cleaning the appropriate parts, noting the wear items, and reassembly. Plus, we'll look at the support available for your WGR with maintenance and toolkits from Stoneage. Before we get started, let's look at the tools required for this maintenance. Items that you'll need to provide are marked with white dots. Items noted in yellow come in the WGR 612 toolkit from your dealer. You'll need 242 Loctite, white grease, blue goop, isopropyl alcohol, a large adjustable wrench, large crescent wrench, a pick, spacers for installing seals, a bearing splitter, seal installer, 3/8 inch socket drive and extension, Torx L key T25, cotton swab, rubber band, modified snap ring pliers, and a special hex nut for turning the shaft when applying viscous fluid. A press and a vise will also come in handy, so let's get started at the vise. The WGR has major components that we will refer to often in this video. They are the head, the front nut, body, centralizing fins, backplate, and inlet nut. There are two port screws in the body, one closer to the head end and another closer to the inlet nut. There are multiple head options available, and the 1-inch inlet comes in either NPT or BSPP. Place the tool in a vise with the head end down using the wrench flats to secure. Take the Torx L key that comes with your purchase and locate the through holes in the front nut. Slide the key into the first hole and then rotate the body until the key slides all the way through as shown. This locks the shaft for the next step, which is to separate the body from the head. Using a large adjustable wrench, loosen the front nut. You can also use the 2.5-inch wrench that comes with your 612 toolkit. Note the L key is still in place. Continue to unscrew the body by hand. Remove the L key and at the same time note the O-ring on the end of the shaft. We'll get to that in a bit. Place the body back in the vise using the flats on the front nut to secure. Next, take a rubber band and stretch it around the centralizing fins as shown. This keeps the fins from falling out all over the place during the next step. Loosen the 6 screws holding the back plate on with your Torx L key wrench. With the 6 screws removed, the back plate will pop off. Now remove the 6 centralizing fins. Set those parts aside for cleaning. Next, locate the weep seal on the inlet nut. Use a pick to remove it, exposing the weep holes underneath. Remove the inlet nut with your large crescent wrench. You may need to apply a little back pressure to get it loose. Take your large adjustable wrench and, using the wrench flats on the body, loosen the inlet nut as shown. Finish unscrewing by hand. Note, there are parts inside the nut. We'll disassemble those in a moment. Now, we'll move to the press. Use your pick to remove the wave spring. Flip the tool now so the head end is up. If you haven't already removed the port screw closest to the head end, do so now. It makes removing the shaft much easier. Press out the shaft. There are several parts to the shaft that we will disassemble in a minute. Head back to the vise where you'll remove the front plate from the body. Secure the body in the vise using the wrench flats on the sides. Using a large adjustable wrench, loosen the front nut and unscrew. The front nut has some remaining items for disassembly. Once again, we'll get to those in a moment. The body still has a seal and some bearings inside, so let's head back to the press to remove those. Set the body on the press with the inlet end facing up. Using the WGR 181 spacer tool, press the remaining items out of the body. We use a shim on top of the spacer as shown. you should have a shaft seal, spacer, and sealed bearing. At this time, the body should be completely stripped, set aside for cleaning. Still at the press, you can now tackle the shaft assembly. Start by removing the WGR 058 high pressure seal with modified snap ring pliers. You can also use the seal puller that comes with your 612 toolkit. With the seal out, use your finger to extract the wave spring. Next, separate the bearing from the assembly. Use a splitter between the bearing ring and the shaft seal. Press the bearing off. The shaft seal and spacer will follow. Note, the shaft still has a couple of O-rings, so head back to the workbench to further disassemble several parts. Start with the body. Remove the last port screw. The inlet nut is next. Using modified snap ring pliers, remove the WGR 059 high pressure seal and wave spring underneath it. These seals may look the same, but they are different. The WGR 058 HP seal is for the shaft, and the WGR 059 HP seal is for the nut. Use a slot screwdriver to gently pry out the shaft seal. There is a small O-ring down inside. Use a pick to remove it and the O-ring from the base of the threads. Set the nut aside for cleaning. Next, repeat with the front nut. Pry out the shaft seal and remove the O-ring from the base of the threads. Finally, the shaft has two O-rings that should be removed, one at each end. Your disassembly is now complete. Wash all appropriate parts in solvent and blow dry. Before reassembly begins, note the wear items. All these items are contained in your overhaul kit, and you should always use the new parts from your kits during reassembly for maximum performance. We will review the kits at the end of this exercise. Begin reassembly at the workbench where you can prep the shaft assembly and the inlet nut. Start with an O-ring on the male end of the shaft and follow with one in the other end. The second O-ring needs to fit into the groove down in the shaft. A pick will help here, along with pinching the O-ring slightly as it goes in. Prep the inlet nut next, starting with a new O-ring. This is like the one you just installed in the shaft. With the O-ring installed, place the wave spring into the nut as shown. Follow that with a greased high pressure seal using the WGR 184 seal installer to position in the inlet nut. Use your thumbs to press it into place evenly. When the seal is properly positioned, you should be able to activate the wave spring by gently pressing down and letting go. Return to the press now, where you will perform several tasks. Start with the inlet nut. Place a new O-ring at the base of the threads. Prep the shaft seal with grease and make certain the lip side of the seal faces down. Press the shaft seal into place using your WGR 182 installing tool, rotating the nut as you press it in. Repeat the procedures with the front nut, applying the large O-ring and pressing the seal into place. Press the grease seal into the nut, all the way down to the shoulder inside. We're using a slightly smaller installing tool here. You may even be able to press it down with your thumbs. Pressing the seal to the shoulder will leave a small 1/16 inch recess, as shown. This is correct. Remember to grease this seal as well and install it with the lip side facing down. Now take the body and stand it so the head end is up. Grease and install the new shaft seal first, with the lip side facing down. Use your WGR 182 installing tool again here. Follow that with a greased spacer. Finally, grease the outside of the new sealed bearing ring and press into place. This bearing has no inner or outer race, so it goes in either way. Brush white grease on top of the bearing before moving on. Replace both port screws. tighten the screw closest to the front end with a screwdriver, but only hand tighten the one nearest the inlet nut. We'll use that port to bleed viscous fluid. Next, screw the front nut into the body, and you can stay right where you are at the press. Brush a little blue goop on the threads of the front nut and screw it into the body. Hand tight is all you need for now. Flip the body so it stands on the front nut as shown. You're ready to install the shaft into the body. It should slide in by hand, but you may need to use the press. The shaft should rest firmly into the body. Now comes the viscous fluid. We use only medium viscosity grade for this tool and include some with your kit. Pour in a generous amount of visc. Work the shaft with a 3/8 inch socket drive and the WGR 183 hex tool to force the air bubbles up and out. The hex tool fits on the end of the socket drive extension, and then you can insert it into the shaft as shown. Pour in some more fluid. This is a slow process, but nonetheless extremely critical. Work the socket drive again to spin the shaft. Important note: rotating the shaft in a counterclockwise manner will utilize the spiral grooves in the shaft, forcing visc down into the body and air bubbles up. Keep pouring and spinning until all the bubbles are out and the fluid level comes up to the shoulder just above the shaft. It is important not to overfill the visc, as that can cause internal damage. Fill only to the shoulder level. Next, install the shaft seal, spacer, and bearing into the body. Grease the seal and place it in the body, ready to install with the lip side down. Now, remove the port screw that was only hand tightened. Use your WGR 182 installing tool to press in the seal. As it goes in, you will see visc oozing from the port. This is to be expected. Wipe off the excess, replace the port screw, and tighten. Brush a little more grease on the top of the seal and then grease the spacer that goes in next. Now press in the greased bearing ring, once again with no inner or outer race. Brush white grease on top of the bearing before moving on. Next, insert a new small wave spring down in the shaft and prepare to place the high pressure seal on top. Grease the seal generously and use the WGR 184 installer tool to place it in the shaft. Press down evenly for a good fit and check your work by activating the wave spring underneath. Generously grease a new large wave spring and place it on top of the bearing. And then we'll head back to the vise for the final steps. Secure the tool in the vise using the flats on the front nut. We've been greasing all parts like crazy, but now we're going to make certain that two small surfaces have no grease. They are the faces on the two high pressure seals, one in the nut and the other in the shaft. Use a cotton swab and some isopropyl alcohol to clean these two surfaces. You're ready to screw the inlet nut back into the body. First, carefully brush a little white grease on the last large wave spring, being careful not to touch the high pressure seal you just cleaned. Apply blue goop to the threads and screw the inlet nut back in. Tighten with a large crescent wrench. You may want a little back pressure. Then flip the big wrench and make sure the body is tight with the front nut. Replace the weep seal on the inlet nut. Place the rubber band around the body and slide the centralizer fins back into their slots. Replace the back plate. Apply Loctite to the six back plate screws and tighten with your Torx L key. Tighten the plate like you would a wheel on your car, alternating sides for an even fit. Remove the rubber band. Finally, screw the body back into the head. Secure the head in the vise using the wrench flats. Brush white grease on the O-ring and blue goop on the threads. Tighten the assembly using your L-key wrench. Locate the holes in the front nut and slide the key through to lock the shaft. hand tighten the assembly at first using the fins as shown. Then use a crescent wrench on the inlet nut to tighten everything up. Your reassembly is now complete. Before we wrap things up, let's look at the support available for your WGR. The fluid kit contains a syringe applicator, 2 port screws, and viscous fluid. The seal kit contains anti-seize, wave springs, high pressure seals, and O-rings. The service kit has a port plug, viscous fluid, anti-seize, O-rings, shaft seals, bearings, spacers, and backplate screws. The overhaul kit contains port screws, viscous fluid, anti-seize, hex socket plug, O-rings, wave springs, shaft seals, bearings, spacers, Torx tool, and high pressure seals. The tool kit contains installing tools for the press, a hex tool, seal puller and seal installation tools, a Torx L-key T25, and a 2.5-inch wrench. Your dealer also has replacement fins, as well as bigger options for larger applications. Maintenance kit breakdowns are also available through your local dealer, in the catalog, and on the web. That's it. As always, if you have any questions or issues, our technical specialists are on hand to help you out. Thanks for watching, and keep on blasting.